already created a bot. Okay, so what it exactly does is, upon taking a request from user with an intent called COVID, it will just give us some reply, or it will go into a particular website and it will scrape the data,
get the output like the active cases and deaths and recovered patients.
Yeah, just a second. I'm just trying to mute everything that's creating a core issue for us.
Yeah.
Okay. So what exactly we need to do right now is to add pull intents.
Yes.
So that whenever a user asks for a different intent, right, we'll get. So for the initial demo purpose, let's not add multiple or many things. Let's add two more intents. Okay. One intent to get the email count.
Okay.
And the second intent to get the time. That's it.
Okay. So let me first create an intent for email ID.
Correct.
But then for email ID, what will be the input from the user?
No, see, this is not an email ID. Let's say that I have 20 emails in my inbox, Outlook inbox.
Okay.
So I'm using this chatbot to check how many emails do I have. That's it, nothing else.
Okay. So
but the basic thing that we are showing is how we are mapping multiple intents. That's it.
Right. But like I will have to add some training faces which will like invoke that particular intent. So what
Correct.
Training faces you want to add for like just testing?
Okay. Show my how many mails do I have in my inbox.
Okay. So we'll create an intent. Let's name it email count.
Get email count.
Okay. Get email. I think first we need to create one entity for like emails.
Okay, go ahead and do it.
Yeah.
First create and save it. Will it not be saved?
Yeah, it will get saved. Get email count.
Yeah. Okay, go to entities.
Yeah.
So if a user asks about email count.
Okay, so let's name it email count, the entity name.
Okay.
Yeah. So emails, my email.
Again, we should have the count as well.
Yeah, it's coming. I am adding like.
Okay.
Total email count.
So can it be like this, like we need to have two intents, one with email and the other with count?
Two intents, like one which will, like what that intents will do, then we can add.
Okay, see here, the problem that we might face is, save it and type in email. Let's see what do we get.
Okay, one second. So let me add first some training phases.
Okay.
So give me my
email count. Okay.
So
email count we have.
Yeah.
Okay. How many emails do I have?
How many emails do I have?
Okay.
Yeah. So more like, would you suggest give me a total?
I think that's not okay. Give me 100 emails count. Also need to mention 100 or red. Like if the user asks how many 100 emails are there, then we need to show only 100 emails.
Yeah, wait, I will change it. 100 mails. Yeah.
100 mail count.
Yeah.
So I think 100 should also be an intent, right? Entity.
Entity, like we will have to add that also. First, let me save this much.
Okay.
I will add it over there.
So So here we need to split it. Like, see here, when we are saying email count, we are not getting multiple inputs.
Yeah.
There will not be multiple entities. Email state, we need to keep one entity, which can be read or unread.
Okay.
In the intent, we need to have one more intent entity as well.
I got your point. So you are telling one we want for defining like the what type of that email is, like read, unread, or some label, and the other one will include count.
Correct.
Okay. So then let's modify and let's delete this unread. So I think in email count, this many, like the reference value are fine, like total email count and all.
Correct. So
let's create one more entity,
which is saying email state.
Okay.
Yep. So we'll get to know which state the email is.
Right. Email state. So read mails, read email. Right?
Correct.
Unread mails, unread emails.
And can you go back to count? Okay, these two should be enough. We need not worry about others. Go to entities again.
Okay, yeah, one second.
Okay, see here, you are asking email count. Can you open that?
Okay.
So here we will have multiple emails. So here define a name called count and then give only the count in it. When we are saying email, everything should follow up like this. See, emails.
Right.
Here in this, we have my email. So because we cannot map everything in the entity.
Right.
Email count should be one entity, right?
Okay.
So
you mean something like this, email count?
Maybe, but the count should be a number. How can we say that it's a number?
Count should be a member of email count, right?
Number, N-U-M-B.
Achha.
It's a digit.
Oh, count, digit.
Yeah, count should be a digit, right?
So that we will need to do in like the intents, like if the user enters some alphabet or something, like you want to change the type of the count.
As created earlier, this should be out argument. Out right. Email right. Count. So when we have out email count from the workflow, it should actually post it here. Your current 100 emails are.
Okay.
Email count is.
Okay.
Count is. Along with that, it should add or whatever the count that we have.
Okay.
Now when we are saving this, see, what are we asking? Give me email count.
Yes.
Okay. Give me email count. Okay, the intent is get email count.
Right.
But again, we need to ask if it is a read email or unread email.
Okay. Yeah. I got your point. One second. So I will do that change. One second. Give me read mails.
So in general, if we didn't mention if it is read mails or unread mails, we need to map it such that it gives you all the count, like it should give you count of read as well as unread.
Okay.
Don't change that. I think you should not change here. Whatever you have done is correct. Go to intents and map it